Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel Be Yourself. This is Dr. Rajni Sharma and today I come up with another discovery which is because of the somatic mutation. Actually, this is a disease which is present in a human, and this is a sad news for the male that they basically male are more affected of this disease, and as these are all X-linked disease, but it is not a genetic disease, rather this is a somatic mutations. So this is a paper published which has found this type of disease, and let's see what exactly this disease is all about. And this finding is well published in the New England Journal of Medicine. So this is a journal where it is published, and this is a well collaborative work of such a huge brain scientist. So let's see what the disease is all about and what it is. So this is actually auto-inflammatory disease, and this disease is basically caused by the deleterious mutations of the ubiquitin related genes, which is the E1 gene, and this E1 gene is well expressed by UBA1 coding region of the DNA, and this UBA1 lies over the X chromosome. This is the basic reason why males are affected of this disease. Though till now no cases were studied in case of female. So out of 25 case study, all the cases all were man, and this work is published on October. So this is just a new discovery. In this, scientist has very well explained in this paper with the help of lots of experimental work. They have also used a number of experimental work, including Sanger sequencing method to show that how this deleterious mutation has taken place. They have also confirmed the role of UBA1 in case of zebrafish by using a knockout method. So I think you all will be knowing about the knockout method. This is just what we do, that the gene of interest which we want to know that what the exactly function of that gene, we use to eliminate that genes from that portion. And in this study, the technique used to eliminate that UBA1 gene is CRISPR-Cas9 technique. So I think you all will be well aware of those techniques. And this disease was known as VEXAS. So what actually is VEXAS syndrome represent? What the abbreviations of this? They were named with the involvement of all the things, all the mechanism in the appearance of this clinical manifestation of this syndrome. So this include basically VEKLs, E1 enzyme, as X-linked and auto-inflammatory and somatic, as for the somatic. So I'm just briefing you about the paper, what they have published here. So moving further toward the inner side of the paper. So what the basic theme, I hope you all understood about what the basic theme of this paper. And yes, about the genetic feature. They study the genetic feature of this VEXAS syndrome, and they have basically isolated and sequenced the hematopoietic cells population. And this hematopoietic cell population basically include the hematopoietic stem cells and myeloid cells. It was seen that UBA1 mosaic mutation was predominant in the wild type of the T and B cells. In B and T cells, wild type were the predominant, whereas the mutant myeloid cells was predominant in the case of neutrophils and monocytes. So actually, they have not sequenced the whole genome. They have only sequenced the exome ones. Exome means what? Only the coding sequence of the genes. And they particularly focus on this UBA1 genes, which is well associated with the innate immunity, and the inflammation, auto-inflammation, which is the term used here, is actually a innate immune response of our body. So I'm directly coming to the figure. They have this figure is pretty good to explain what they have found. what they did, they have taken the samples which were having the clinical manifestation, and they have also taken some of the sample who were undiagnosed of the disease. After proper Sanger sequencing, what they found, they have actually taken the three patients, 1, 2, and 3. What they found, a particular site of the E1 enzyme, which is the 41 position, which should consist of the methionine, were undergo mutation. So when they compared the mosaic mutant one with the reference one, what they found, so here you can see, instead of the T, here C is present. And if you will be, even if you are having the basic idea of the Sanger sequencing method, you will see that mostly the results come in such types of peak with different colors representing four nucleotides A, T, G, C. So here we can see that mosaic one, the mutant one, is having a replacement of C instead of, or the cytosine instead of the thymidine. Whereas in patient 2, there is a mutation from A to G, and in patient 3, again there is T to C mutation. And when they studied these types of mutation in the peripheral blood cells, what they find that here the blue one will represent you the mutant one, and the red color represent you the wild one. So as the statement which was used above here, as they said that the UBA1 mosaic mutants has predominantly wild type lymphocytes in T and B cells. So let's see, in the T and B cells, we will see that the red one, which is representing you the wild type. So we can see here T and B cells are having the predominance of the wild type, whereas the other cells, including monocytes and neutrophils, macrocaryotes, erythroblasts, previously the MEPs. So all these were having the higher rate of the mutant cells. So, or we can say that these cells were more affected of this mutations of UBA1 mutations, which is causing this autoinflammatory diseases, which they have termed as a VEXA syndrome. Now the patients also, what they find when they studied about the details of the patients, as these are well involved in the inflammation, and we all know that in inflammation cytokines are well responsible. So they have also diagnosed about, and they have also compared that with the control one, those who are not having such symptoms, that what actually the cytokines concentration are there in the control and the diseased one. So what they find, here in one diagram, yes, in this diagram they have represented that in the case of VEXAS syndrome people, they were having a high concentration of the C reactive protein. These dashed line, I think it might be visible to you very clearly, this dashed line is representing the normal level of the C reactive protein. So this C reactive protein usually increases in concentration in the case of inflammation. So you can see how largely this inflammation-regulating proteins has been increased in the case of VEXAS syndrome. Not only this, rather in the control, compare with the other cytokines, then we'll find that the interleukin, interferons, and IP protein is also increased in the case of VEXAS syndrome. And now coming to the symptoms, what the symptoms they will be having. So they basically have the inflammation in the pulmonary arteries, and there exists in the cartilage also. There you can see the inflammation, particularly in the ears and nose. So they have used all the terminology here in the clinical manifestations, which include alveolitis, which means the inflammation of the pulmonary arteries, ears and lung chondritis, which is the inflammation of the cartilage bone, skin lesions, and thromboembolic disease, which leads to the decrease in the concentration of platelets one. So all these are the basic symptoms, and the patients in which they have studied were basically having here, they have, if you will go through this table, you will have a complete knowledge of what exactly the whole paper is all about. So though I have already summarized you, but here once again, what they have did, they have studied in the three patients where there were the mutation with T2C mutation, A2G mutation and A2C mutations, and in 15 of the cases, they found mutations at this position. Where there is T2C mutations at the 122 site, whereas there is a deleterious mutations of 121 site of A2G and 121 site of A2C. So only the other 10 were having these types of mutations, but basically predominant one is this one, this particular first one. And the clinical manifestation is well represented by here with the percentage, the 23% were having fever, 22 were have involvement of the skin, pulmonary inflammation, and we have also seen in the figures also which they have provided with the ear and nose chondritis or the inflammation of the cartilage, thromboembolus and macrocytic anemia, bone marrow vacuole. So all these are the common clinical manifestation which they have observed. So these were all about the short review of over this on this paper. If you want to read more about this paper, this is freely available, but it is for the shorter period of time. You have to log in when you will go to the this journal. You will have to log in, and then after that only you can download this PDF. So I have logged in and it was freely available. It is for the limited time. If you want to study, you can go through this paper. Hope you like this video about this new discovery. So don't forget to subscribe and share my channel. So along with the subjective questions and topics, I will keep on explaining about all this research also. So don't forget to subscribe and share my channels, and do share with your friends.